For those of you looking at switching to a Tesla or just want to learn more about how charging a Tesla works, we first have to start off by understanding the three core levels of charging, level 1, 2, and 3. My name is Evan, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. If not, welcome back. Each level of charging delivers different electric charging speeds, and each Tesla model will have a different maximum charge they can accept. Choosing the right method to charge can minimize hassle, range anxiety, and installation costs. This will in turn maximize your overall enjoyment of driving a Tesla. A big shout out to today's sponsor, OptiWatt. OptiWatt allows you to maximize your charging efficiency by setting it to automatically schedule your Tesla to charge during the cheapest electricity rates, all while tracking your exact spending. Users save on average 70% when charging their Tesla using OptiWatt. Set your desired battery target and departure time and OptiWatt will handle the rest. Oh, and the best part is, it's free. Check out the link below to sign up today. Let's get back to it. First, we have to understand that an EV charger can be referred to as two separate things, the internal and external charger. First, we have the internal onboard charger, which is built inside the Tesla, which manages incoming power flow to safely charge the car's battery. Second, we have the external charger, also known as the EVSE, which stands for Electric Vehicle Supply Equipment. The EVSE provides power from the grid or even Tesla's Powerwall and solar panels to your Tesla's internal onboard charger. Most people in general, though, just call an EVSE a charger. Now that we understand the charging components of a Tesla, the level at which we charge these vehicles can vary depending on the amount of amps and volts flowing into the Tesla. This is where level 1, 2, and 3 come into play. Start off with level 1, which is typically rated at 120 volts that may range from 15 to 20 amps. It's a very common outlet found in every home and business across the United States. Charging your Tesla Model 3 on a level 1 basis, for example, would get you about 3 to 6 miles per hour charge, with the average owner seeing about 4.4 miles per hour, equating to roughly 40 miles added range in about 9 hours overnight. While this may not seem feasible, I want to point out that most Americans only drive about 29.2 miles per day, according to an article by AAA. In my opinion, if you are one of these people that drives under 40 miles per day, relying solely on the level 1 charge receptacle may be a viable option for you. I personally use this option because I typically drive around 40 miles a day. However, if you reside in a state that charges by time of use, you may want to consider upgrading to the next charge level. I recently started plugging in at my employer to help offset the electricity costs at my home, which brings us on to the next tier of charging, level 2. Level 2 charging is the most popular way for Tesla owners to charge their car at home. Level 2 charges 4 to 10 times faster than the typical level 1 charger. It is the most efficient and least stressful way to charge. Charging at this level will require additional equipment along with added installation costs. A 240 volt receptacle, like your closed dryer outlet at home, will need to be installed. Typically, a NEMA 1450 plug is the most common. However, other level 2 receptacles will work just fine. As you can see here, Tesla offers plenty of adapters to fit the included mobile charger that comes standard with all Teslas. Another option is to purchase Tesla's wall connector, which will eliminate the need to install a NEMA 1450 receptacle, but rather just running new wiring through your home. This will also eliminate the need to use the mobile connector to charge your car. One thing I like to point out is that the Tesla wall connector will charge slightly faster at a maximum 48 amps, providing an estimated 44 miles per hour charge to the Model 3, versus the mobile connector that charges at a maximum 32 amps, providing you an estimated 30 miles per hour charge for the Model 3. I know I just threw a lot of information to you at once, but you really have to understand your specific driving habits and how much you are willing to spend on a level 2 wire installation. Installation costs will range depending on how far your breaker box is from your Tesla. The further the distance, the more the cost in labor and wire installation can add up. I've heard costs can range from as little as $50 when installing a receptacle yourself, all the way to $2,000. Now, I'm going to state the obvious. Please note that when working with electricity, it is extremely dangerous work. Do not skip corners to save yourself money on installation costs. Please work with a certified electrician if you are not familiar with electric wiring. Now that I got that out of the way, another fee to incorporate is the Tesla wall connector that costs an additional $500. So if you are wanting that extra 14 miles per hour charge and the nice looking Tesla wall connector in your garage, that's a viable fair opinion. However, I would recommend if you are looking to upgrade to a level 2 connection that you install a NEMA 1450 outlet. You can purchase a 1450 adapter for $35 for your Tesla mobile connector that comes with the car, and the Tesla Model 3 will charge at 32 amps, providing you 30 miles per hour charge charge, which is typically more than enough to charge the entire car overnight when you're sleeping. Now remember I said earlier that different models of Teslas will charge at different rates, even if using the same receptacle outlet. Looking at the chart here from Tesla's website, we can see when using the mobile connector with the 1450 adapter again, rated at a maximum charge at 32 amps, a Model X, for example, will only charge at 20 miles per hour, rather than the Model 3 at 30 miles per hour. Now let's look at when using the Tesla wall connector, that is rated again at a maximum 48 amp output, the Model X will now receive 30 miles per hour charge compared to 20 using the mobile connector. We can also see that the Model 3 gets an estimated 44 miles per hour charge rather than 30 using the mobile connector. After all this is said regarding level 2 charging at home, you have to ask yourself, do I need a wall connector that costs $500? Do I need that extra 14 miles per hour charge? You very well might need it. Only you can answer that question as you know your specific driving habits. Regardless to which type of level 2 receptacle you choose, remember to sign up for OptiWatt to help offset the electricity costs at home. If you live in a state where energy prices vary depending on time of day, OptiWatt has you covered by automatically optimizing your charge efficiency based on your utility provider rates and home address. Charge your Tesla the smart way with OptiWatt. And by the way, it's free to use. Try it today, it only takes a few seconds to set up. You may also ask, what are these ChargePoint, EVgo, and Blink stations about? What charge level are they at? Most of these stations are level 2 chargers that supply for the most part the same amount of electricity we talked about earlier, and most are free to use. A lot of these stations also have the popular J1772 plug that will not work with your Tesla unless you have the adapter, which I highly recommend getting from Tesla's website if it didn't come with your car. Many employers and corporations are starting to add electric vehicle charging stations at the workplace as benefits and amenities to attract and retain top talent. Which is my next question for you. Does your employer or future employer have one of these level 2 charging stations? If so, you may want to think twice about adding a level 2 charger port in your home at all. Remember I said earlier, I do not have a level 2 charger in my home due to the fact that I can plug in at work on a level 2 basis. I can charge the entire car during my 8-hour shift no problem. It also helps that I only have to drive 16 miles round trip to and from work daily. Honestly, in my Tesla Model 3 mid-range, I can get by with charging only once a week at work, and the best part is that it's free. If you are curious on where to find these public and or private chargers, I recommend downloading the PlugShare app, which will show all level 1, 2, and 3 chargers nearest to you. One final thought I want to talk about with the level 2 chargers is that many states offer lucrative tax rebates to install one of these receptacles in your home. I'll post a couple links in the description below with all the states and their rebates. Regardless, if you don't think you need one installed, see what incentives your state of residence is offering. They may end up refunding all, if not most, of the cost to install a level 2 receptacle. In my opinion, this is a home improvement accessory adding to the resale value of your home, just like solar panels on your roof. As electric vehicle sales continue to grow, more and more consumers are going to be looking at this added amenity in their future home. If you still have questions or think I missed something about the level 2 chargers, please comment down below and I promise to respond back to you. Finally, we have the last charging tier, level 3. At this level, we are able to charge the Tesla at rapid speeds, which is why the Tesla supercharger network comes in handy, especially when taking long distance road trips. All Tesla superchargers are at level 3, adding roughly 170 miles of range in about 30 minutes. Charging at level 3 is also known as DC charging or direct current. When charging at this level, the DC power bypasses the Tesla's onboard charger, meaning the electricity can feed directly to the car's battery, whereas level 1 and 2 are using the alternating current or AC, which will flow through the Tesla's onboard charger as we discussed earlier. All DC chargers like the Tesla supercharger have built-in chargers, also known as the converter. The Tesla supercharger network is one of the many reasons why Tesla has been growing at a rapid pace. Their network allows you to drive anywhere without having to run out of power. Most of these level 3 chargers are located along major highways and are within walking distance to restaurants, shops, and restrooms. My girlfriend and I actually use the supercharger network occasionally when we take a road trip to the beach here in North Carolina. The car will intelligently inform you how long you have to charge to reach your destination. From my personal experience, we've had to stay no longer than 25 minutes at a supercharger to make it back home. Though depending on where you live, I see many Tesla owners complaining about extreme wait times to use a supercharger, especially in the state of California. Here in the East, I have yet to experience this, knock on wood. By the time you stretch your legs, use the restroom, grab a snack, it's already time to go. Tesla also started installing new version 3 superchargers, meaning the car will charge up to speeds of 250 kilowatts, rather than version 2 charging at 150 kilowatts. To put this equation into miles, 250 kilowatts equates to about 1,000 miles per hour charge, rather than 150 kilowatts at about 500 miles per hour charge. According to Tesla, version 3 superchargers will add about 75 miles of range in only 5 minutes. With this amount of electricity, the consumer will see fast charging experiences at an unprecedented scale compared to other vehicle manufacturers. Not all superchargers are version 3, but Tesla continues to expand and upgrade their network as more and more consumers switch to Tesla. Charging costs at a Tesla supercharger can vary based on city and state. Typically, sessions to charge are between $9 and $20 to fully charge your Tesla. Still beats refueling a comparable luxury vehicle like an Audi A4 with premium gasoline at $40 to $50 to refuel the full tank. Just remember that charging at home will always be the cheapest way to charge your Tesla. Supercharger rates are nearly double the cost than charging at home. Unless, of course, you plug in for free at work, you find a free public charger, or have free supercharger miles from referrals. If you're looking at purchasing a Tesla here in the future, check out my referral link below for free supercharger miles for yourself. Now, with all this information I have thrown at you, choosing the right method to charge your Tesla while saving money can be challenging. Here's a basic tree diagram I have created to help you find a possible solution. Again, this is a very generic chart that I put together that excludes rebates and costs, but rather helps you find a method to charge based on your driving habits. I'll post a link for this image as well in the description below. If you found this video informative, consider hitting that like button down below and consider subscribing for more content like this in the future. I hope I've answered a lot of your questions regarding which charge level is best for you. Remember, if you have any questions about the complete charging guide, please comment down below and I'll be sure to get back to you. Until the next video, guys, stay safe and I'll see you all in the next one.